In this video, I'll show you how to take your truck from this to this with zero physical contact. Let's get into it.
You could probably shovel this off.
Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to get into our most popular kit ever. This is the one that put us on the map. The Touchless Foam Cannon Kit. The Stars and Stripes edition, no less. This is going to be a lot of fun because we have a truck behind us that is super filthy and it's black. So it's going to show all the stuff that is left over. And there will be a little bit of stuff left over. It's not going to get us 100% of the way there, but it's going to take us pretty darn close. And up here in New England with all these winter issues we have, like salt, corrosion, you just want to get that off of there, look good going down the road, maybe look pretty good up close too. You know, we're going to take some close looks at this and wipe our fingers across the thing when we're done and see how much of the road film's left over. Let's open up the kit and I'll show you what's included. I want to give you a few tips as far as how to set up your foam cannons. There's a couple things you can do to get better foam, and also some of the techniques to use with this kit to get the best results you possibly can. Okay, two MTM Hydro PF22s. We got our pre-soak and our neutralizer, along with a nice directions card to help you out a little bit, and a funnel to get these into those. Let's pop these open and I'll show you some tips how to set them up nice. We got a little user manual thing. We've got the head of the foam cannon, the bottle, which is a nice design of the PF22.2. This comes with both style of the most common quick disconnects that you'll see out there, the 22 millimeter screw coupler or the QC. The QC is the one I roll with. You're just gonna screw that right on right here. What I like to do, now this is a little pro tip, these come with this. This is the smaller orifice. So what's installed in this when you get it is the 1.25 millimeter nozzle, and that's a 3.5 in normal sizes. This is one size smaller, it's a 3.0 or a 1.1 millimeter. And so basically the smaller the hole here, the more foam this puts out. So if you're struggling with your foam quality and you wanna amp it up a little bit, this is one thing you might wanna do. Especially on a smaller power washer, and you'll get a little thicker foam out of that. The way to install that is you take a flathead, you're gonna wanna back out the one that's in there, just like that. Then you take this one and throw that in there. I'm rolling with the smallest ones here at my wash bay just because I wanna try and get the most foam I can. Even though my power washers are not super small, my spec here is 2,500 PSI at 4 gallons per minute. So these are pretty good sized machines, but I just want to try and maximize how much foam I get out of these. I'm going to take the QC fitting, let's thread it right on here. You're just going to want two wrenches so you can tighten this fitting down. Get down there good and snug, and always line up your hexagons. Boom. You're going to put your pickup tube onto this little barb underneath here. Now this is ready to rock and roll. Bam. This also comes, I should have put this on there, this comes a little cap for this bottle too, just in case you have soap left over and you want to just seal it up, put it aside. Because it's always good to rinse these out when you're done with them, just to keep them from clogging up. One other thing that we include that I forgot to mention is this foam agitator pad. This is a replacement, just in case you clog up the foam cannon with some coil scale or some sand or grit. We have some other content of how to get this in there, but it's a super quick fix in case that comes up. Come on back here, we're gonna check out what we did yesterday. We did a small test spot. And this will give you an idea of what we can expect from this stuff. Hey, oh, Nate! Oh, yeah. This is a test area, because we wanted to make sure that our soaps were going on at a good strength that would get the job done. So we just let it dry, took a good look at it, and I'm pretty happy with how we mixed them. So let's get into that now. I'll show you guys how we mix the soaps to get these results on this. Okay, so we got 3/4 water in both these foam cannons, which leaves room for 1/4 of soap over that. Now this is just a starting point. Let me tell you why. There's three main factors that are gonna determine how strong you wanna mix your soaps. First one is hardness of your water. The harder your water, the more soap it's gonna take to get a good result. Second factor is how dirty is what you're cleaning. The dirtier it is, the more soap you're gonna wanna use. Third factor is what temperature is it outside. Soaps are activated more by heat, like in the summertime or in the sunlight, and they're inhibited a little bit by cold weather, like in the winter. So you're gonna wanna use more soap, a little stronger in the wintertime and less in the summertime. The real thing you wanna do is just start at this strength and then try a small spot like we just did and see how it did. If there's still road film left over, then you're gonna wanna use more soap, or you're gonna wanna rinse maybe a little closer with your power washer. But if you're not seeing any road film left over, then maybe you could stretch it just a little further and get a little more bang for your buck. Step one, I'm gonna put on our pre-soak first. I got my top knob all the way tight. It's gonna give me the most strength coming out of this thing so we can do the most work. Spread this fan out here. Yeah, here we go. This both steps, and now we're gonna rinse real good. We're gonna stay at about 1 foot distance from the surface because the pressure is a big part of the whole process and getting the last of the road film off. This two-step process will loosen the road film, but it's the pressure that gets the road film off at the very last end of it. And so you wanna rinse real thoroughly. I like to rinse from the bottom up because it helps me keep the track where I've been with the pressure a little bit, and I just find that it works better for me. Final rinse will still be top down though. This is a great example of washing in sections because in a truck this size, I like to do about 1/4 of the truck at a time. And the only reasoning I have there is that I just don't want the soaps to dry before I rinse them. So let's get to the back of this truck now. We've got some real heavy buildup to knock down first there before we put the soaps on, and then we'll see how that turns out. Would you look at this? This is a good 2.5 inches thick right here. Could probably shovel this off first, I guess. We'll just have some fun and blast it all over the walls. Almighty finger test. Yes. This is what I like to see. Damn. Look at that reflection. Look at that. Still some stuff here and there. And that's why I say you're gonna get 90% of the way there. This is not the complete solution. And that's why I make other things like Liquid X or our new foam wash that's coming out. You're gonna wanna every now and then take it 100%. This is just a shortcut. It's a really good shortcut, but a shortcut nonetheless. Now this rim, aluminum looks good. It's clean. The rubber came out fantastic. Man. That's beautiful. You can still see some stuff. And this is where our M-Shine aluminum cleaner would come into play. You would put that on at like 10:1, maybe wipe it around with a brush and rinse it off. And that would get you the 100%, at least aside from things like polishing. I mean, obviously my soaps need a polished surface underneath all the grime at some point. My stuff won't polish the aluminum for you, but it can help save you some time and make the upkeep a little easier. But this system does absolutely marvelous on the chrome and the polished aluminum. And just helps save a ton of time. I think my favorite part of this job is when our customers realize how much time they can save, because it's substantial. This system is like 75% faster than hand washing. Drying off the vehicle is so important. I have not the greatest water here, and that's semi-intentional because I want to embrace the factors that my customers face. So that's why I use cold water, and that's why I like to see what we can do with 4 or 5 grain water hardness. And I'm pretty happy with this. This is pretty darn good. I could have dried a little bit better. My backpack blower ran out of gas. I mean, considering that a process like this takes 20 minutes, you could go over this with a quick detailer if you wanted and get 100% of the way there, but we're just seeing what we can do without physical contact. How'd the back turn out? Well, there's less mud and stuff, but yeah, this is a paving truck, man.
What you heard? It's what you hearing. What you hearing? It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. X gon' give it to ya. What? Wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to ya. Knock, knock. Open up the door. It's real. With